Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create exquisite portraits filled with text of the person's name. Before we begin, if you're not a subscriber to my channel, hit that small subscribe button at the lower right corner. If my tutorials have helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, I'd like to ask you to help support my channel by becoming a channel member or by becoming a patron. Click the join button below the video or click the Patreon card at the upper right corner. You'll receive early access to watch my new tutorials 1 week before the public can see them, and you'll receive 10% off all of my merchandise sold at Redbubble and Teespring. Open a photo of someone that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to create a new document by going to File and New. Make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. Its color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Its background color is irrelevant since we're going to fill it with a custom gradient. Click the adjustment layer icon and click gradient. Click the gradient bar and click the black to white gradient preset. Click the lower left stop and the color box. Pick a color you like. Since I already know the color I like, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field. 82FEFF. Then click OK on both windows to close them. Make the style radial, the angle 90 degrees, and the scale 300%. Check reverse and click OK. Open your horizontal type tool. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Black should be your foreground color. Open your font picker and pick a bold font. I'm using Arial Bold. I'll make its size 20 points and the anti-aliasing sharp. Click on your document and type out your subject's name. We're going to make the text into a custom brush. First, temporarily hide the two layers under your text and go to Image and Trim. Tick Transparent Pixels and make sure all the boxes are checked. Go to Edit and Define Brush Preset. Type in the name of your subject. Open the History panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and History. Click the bottom Modify Gradient Fill layer to revert your document back before you trimmed it. It'll also keep the new custom brush that you created of the name. To check it, open your brush list. At the bottom of the panel, you'll see the custom brush of the name you typed out. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Name it Large Text. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your brush settings. Another way is to go to Window and Brush Settings. In the Brush Tip Shape window, make the size 700 pixels and the spacing 500%. Check Shape Dynamics. Make the size jitter 40%. The controls are off and the remaining amounts are 0%. Check Scattering. The scatter amount is 50%. The controls are off, the count is 1, and the count jitter is 0%. Check Smoothing. Close the panel and brush over the center part of your document until it fills it with approximately this much of your text. make a new layer, and temporarily hide the large text layer. Reduce the size of your brush by making sure your caps lock key is off and pressing the left bracket key on your keyboard twice. The size should be 500 points. If it isn't, just type it in. As before, brush over the center part of your document until it's filled with approximately this much of your text. Make a new layer and temporarily hide the layer under it. Reduce its size to 300 points. Again, brush over the center of your document until it's filled with approximately this much of your text. We'll convert each of the text layers into smart objects so we can add filters to them non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner and click Convert to Smart Object. You know it's a smart object when you see this icon at its lower right corner. Make the middle text visible and active and convert it into a smart object as well. Repeat this with the bottom text layer. Hide the middle and top text layers. Click the FX icon and click Color Overlay. Click the color box and pick a color for your largest text. I'll type in 002BCC. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 7 pixels and click OK. Reduce the opacity to 45%. Hide the layer and make the middle text layer visible. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. Pick a color for the medium-sized text. I'll type in 00BCAD. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. This time, blur it 4 pixels and reduce its opacity to 85%. Hide the layer and make the top layer visible. As before, double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. Pick a color for your smallest text. I'll type in 003E16. Name the top layer smallest text. To save space, collapse the effects. Name the middle text layer medium text and collapse its effects. Make the rest of the text layers visible and collapse the effects of the large text. We'll group all the text layers into a folder by clicking the top layer and shift-clicking the bottom text layer. Press Ctrl or Command G. Name the folder Text. Click the layer mask icon to create a layer mask next to the folder. We'll be adding some text onto the layer mask later, which will show through all the text layers within the folder. Click the tab of your subject to open it. We want to separate our subject from its background by making a selection around our subject. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, drag it over your subject. To remove selections outside your subject, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To check your selection, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. Note any areas that need correcting. Press Q again to revert it back into a selection and make any necessary corrections. If you want to refine your subject's edges, go to Select. If you're using version 2015.5 or later, click Select and Mask. However, if you prefer to use Refine Edge, press and hold Shift as you click it. If you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, just click Refine Edge. I did in-depth tutorials on both Select and Mask and Refine Edge, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links as well. Check Smart Radius. This enables the tool to detect which areas of your subject are hard and soft. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Drag the tool over the soft edges of your subject like the hair. Check Decontaminate Colors. This prevents color fringing, which are colors that may be leaching into the edges of your subject from the background. I'll drag it to 100%. Output it to a new layer. To place your cutout subject onto your text, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of your text document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize it, press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. If you don't see the Transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag your subject. Then press Enter or Return twice. To zoom back out, press Ctrl or Command and the plus sign on your keyboard. Next, we'll mask out areas of your subject with text. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to your active subject. Open the text folder and Ctrl-click or Command-click the thumbnail of the smallest text to make a selection of it. Press Ctrl plus Shift as you click the thumbnail of the medium text to add its selection to the existing selection, and repeat this for the large text. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Collapse the folder. We'll fill the selection with black, and since black is your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Notice, since the layer mask is active, the black fills the layer mask. Delete the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Convert your subject with its layer mask into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Make a layer mask next to it because we're going to add text onto the layer mask later. But first, we're going to add text to the layer mask next to the text folder. Make the text layer mask active and press B on your keyboard to open back your brush tool. Click your mouse or pen each time you want to place the text over your image, and feel free to adjust its size using the bracket keys. Make the subject's layer mask active. We'll brush in text over the face through the layer mask, but first, we'll reduce the brush's opacity to 30%. Brush over the face. This masks out the areas inside the text through the layer mask. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change its blend mode to hard light. Make the bottom subject active and reduce its opacity to 50%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!